Science Education now. It's your girl Chima Menajiba, and we are still on mathematics. Today our topic is going to be weight. What is weight?
Weight is a measure of how heavy an object is.
Weight is a measure of how heavy an object is.
It is measured in grams and kilograms.
It is measured in grams and kilograms.
Now I have a standard formula here which says 1 kilogram is equal to 1,000 grams.
Now I'm going to teach you how to change from grams to kilograms and from kilograms to grams. So first of all, changing from grams to kilograms. Let's look at some example. Example 1, we have change 500 grams to kilogram. First thing you do is write your standard units. 1 kilogram equals to 1,000 grams. Then, because this is 500 grams, you put it under the gram space. We have s kilogram, because we are changing to kilogram. We put x kilogram equals to 500 grams. So cross multiply. After cross multiply, we say x times 1,000 should give us x times 1,000 and 1 times 500, which is what is it? So x times 1,000 is 1,000x and 1 times 500 is 500. Now we want to make x stand alone, so we have to get rid of this 1,000. To get rid of it, you have to divide both sides by 1,000. So this 1,000 will cancel this 1,000, leaving us with x. Then this will come down. We have x equals to 500 divided by 1,000 equals to 0.5 kilogram. This is very easy. Count the number of zeros, 1, 2, 3. Then you move the zeros, 1, 2, 3. So we have a decimal place here. That's why we have 0.5. See, the point is in front of the 5. So the second example, we have changed 3,500 grams to kilogram. You write your standard unit, which says 1 kilogram is equal to 1,000 grams. Then, S kilogram is equal to 3,500 grams. Because we are changing 3,500 grams to kilogram. So, you cross multiply. We have X times 1,000, which is what we have here. And 1 times 3,500, which is what we have here. X times 1,000 is 1,000X. Equals to 1 times 3,500 is 3,500. To get rid of the 1,000, divide both sides by 1,000. So this 1,000 will cancel this 1,000, leaving us with x. So we have x equals to this divided by this. You count your zeros again. We have 3 zeros here, 1, 2, 3. So you move from here, 1, 2, 3. So the point is going to be in between 3 and 5. As I would say, x is equal to 3.5 kilograms. Now let's look at changing from kilograms to grams. We have an example here which says change 3 kilograms to gram. So we have our standard unit, you say 1 kilogram equals to 1,000 gram. Now, since we are changing to gram, our x is going to be under the gram column here. But this 3 kilogram is going to be under the 1 kilogram. So we have cross multiply, we have x times 1, which is what we have here, and 3 times 1,000, which is what we have here. X times 1 will give us x, and 3 times 1,000 will give us 3,000 grams. So I've converted 3 kilograms to grams. Our second example, we have changed 0.402 kilograms to grams. So you first of all write a standard unit which says 1 kilogram equals to 1,000 grams. So write our 0.402 kilograms equals to x. We're looking for the gram. So say x, we cross multiply, we have x times 1, which is what we have here, and 0.402 times 1,000, which is what we have here. So x times 1 is x, 1,000 times 0.402 will give us 402. This is because of these 3 zeros, so I have 1, 2, 3. So you move 1, 2, 3. So the point is outside. That is like the point that we have here. So we have 0.402 grams. So that is our answer for this one. This is our answer. So I have an assignment here for you. And I'll be expecting your answer in the comment box below. But the assignment says change the following grams to kilograms. So we have 70,054 grams, we have 5,600 grams, and we have 200 grams. You change these ones to kilograms. Then you change the following kilograms to grams. We have 0.527 kilograms, 72 kilograms, and 5 kilograms. You change them to grams. So I'll be expecting your answer. Don't forget to post your answers. Love you all. Share this video to your friends, your family. Subscribe, and I'm expecting to see you in our next class. Love you.